Now, chapter 21, Jesus enters Jerusalem officially, cleanses the temple, curses the fig tree. When he is challenged by the chief priests and elders, he condemns them by parables of the two sons and the householder whose servant slew his son. This is another great chapter. Why, we got 28 great chapters in Matthew. Now, will you look at this? When they drew nigh unto Jerusalem and were come to Bethphage, under the Mount of Olives, and that's right there at the Mount of Olives, it's on the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, go into the village over against you. Straightway ye shall find an ass tied, and a colt with her. Loose them, and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, the Lord hath need of them, and straightway he'll send them. Now, I see no point reading in a miracle here, and I've heard so much made of this. I think it's better to look at it in the normal, natural way in which it's given to us. And that's just simply this. Our Lord, when he was in Jerusalem the last time, had told these friends there, I'm coming here, and probably had disclosed to them what he intended to do. And he asked, I'm sure, that they had furnished the little animal for him. They agreed to it, and they said, we'll have it ready. And I think it was to be agreed at the Passover feast. And they had it already tied. Oh, I think it's so much more wonderful that way. And he said, I'll send one of my disciples or a couple of them in to get the little animal. And when they come to get it, you better question them and make sure. And I'll tell them what to say. Now he tells them, if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, the Lord hath need of them, and straightway he'll send them. All this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, and this, of course, is in Zechariah 9:9, tell ye the daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh unto thee, meek, and sitting upon an ass, and a foal of an ass. The very interesting thing is that if you go back to Zechariah 9:9, you're going to find that we don't have the total quotation here at all. Actually, Zechariah 9:9, rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding upon an ass and upon a colt, the foal of an ass. Now, there are certain important omissions in the quotation in Matthew, which a very careful comparison will reveal. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion, is omitted. Why? He's not coming in now for this time of rejoicing. That'll take place at his second coming. Likewise, he is just and having salvation, and the word salvation is victory. That was not that. The conclusion to be drawn is that these portions will be fulfilled at the second coming, and that will be the true triumphal entry. Now, this is in fulfillment of the part that is quoted here. Now, it is assumed that he was meek because he was riding upon this little animal. Friends, that's not true. That little animal was ridden by kings. That would be just like come riding in today in a Rolls Royce. The little animal, this little donkey, was the animal of peace, and kings rode upon it. And actually, by riding upon the little animal, he's offering himself as king. And in spite of the fact he's doing that, why, the prophet says he's humble. That's important to see, and I think very important to see. Now, will you notice? And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the ass and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and they set him thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees, strawed them in the way. And the multitudes that went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And when he was coming to Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, who is this? And the multitude said, this is Jesus, the prophet of Nazareth of Galilee. Well, that same multitude just in a few days will say,